News today that reminded so many of us of the unsettling times that came with those banking failures back in 2008. Tonight, a bank has been seized by state and federal regulators. This is the biggest bank failure since 2008. And this evening, so many customers demanding to know, where is our money? Now, this bank, the Silicon Valley Bank, a favorite of the tech industry. Customers today rushing to withdraw their money, finding branch offices closed and ATMs not working. Tonight here, the White House is pressed. Could other banks be next, and what safeguards are in place? Here's our senior White House correspondent, Mary Bruce, tonight.
From New York to California today, panicked customers scrambling to pull their money out of Silicon Valley banks, only to find them closed.
All our money is in the bank. I don't know how we're going to do our payroll. I don't know what we're going to do now.
It's the biggest bank failure since the 2008 financial crisis. Regulators this morning shutting down and seizing the assets of the bank, a go-to lender to the tech industry. Many of those businesses today cut off from their cash.
I hope we get most of it back, but yeah, it's definitely a concern.
It all came crashing down in just 48 hours. As the bank tried to shore up its finances, the panic only spread on Wall Street. The bank's stock plunged and customers started pulling their money out.
Once that happens, it's just inevitable it's going to fail.
High interest rates have left many tech companies with less cash on hand, forcing them to withdraw more to meet their expenses.
This is a bank, perhaps a handful of banks that are getting nailed by the fallout from the problem in the tech sector. And it's not a economy-wide or a banking system-wide problem.
We pressed the White House on what this means for the tech world.
How concerned are you that we could see a ripple effect just throughout this specific sector?
I just want to reemphasize that we are in a fundamentally different position, that you know, with the reforms of the global financial crisis of 2007, 2008, we've put in place stress tests and other tools that our regulators have to provide more resilience to our banking system.
Mary, we all listened to that closely today, right there with you. The White House saying safeguards are in place since 2008, obviously trying to ease jitters about other banks, but this was unsettling today. In the meantime, while we have you, Mary, the other news today, this was a major economic headline, the new jobs report, and again, it was much better than expected.
These numbers, again, beating expectations, David. 311,000 jobs were added last month, fueled by gains in hospitality, healthcare, and the retail sector. And the unemployment rate ticked up to 3.6%. The president today was very pleased with these numbers, hailing them as a clear sign that the economy, he says, is headed in the right direction. David.
Right. Mary Bruce on a Friday night. Mary, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.